Hi, everybody. I'm Ken.
I'm Dave.
We're here at the Toy Soldier in Amesbury, Massachusetts for another Saturday Night Rumble.
We got Greg playing Trollbloods, which is interesting tonight.
And we got Todd playing Circle.
Welcome, everybody, to another edition of Saturday Night Rumble. We've got Greg playing Trolls, actually, and Todd playing Circle of Ouroboros.
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 The Druid guys.
This is the Druid guys.
This is actually not a regular faction for either of them.
Frickin' hippies.
We kind of had to dig up the cards for the trolls because we didn't have them.
Greg is playing Madrak1, oddly enough. He's got a full unit of Trollkin champions. He's got Lanyssa. He's got a Stone Scribe Chronicler. Janissa, not to be confused with Lanyssa. And Madrak has a Dire Troll Mauler, an Axer, and an Impaler.
I always love the basics. When you get to Hordes, the initial release models, like the Mauler and the Axer and the Impaler, I always found so much more fun than some of the later ones, especially for Trolls.
Well, too, the Axer's got Rush, Mauler's got Rage. What more do you need on big angry Trollers?
Well, and there's just nothing more humorous than having an Impaler pin somebody to a wall.
Yeah.
Just getting that crit and just being like, woo-doo! I think it knocks down, right? I think on a crit hit, it's a push and knockdown.
Oh, it's a slam.
Yeah. Slam. Yeah. Yeah. So, push, knockdown, on a light jack with snipe.
Stuff. Yeah.
Yeah. And always a good time.
Just enough fury to do all of it.
Well, it's a thrown weapon, so if you have a strength buff, it adds to the ranged weapon too, which is always fun.
Like, say, rage. No, I guess you can't rage in snipe.
No, but rage has range, right? It's not self. Right. So you could have the caster put on rage. But you can't
rage and snipe. Yeah. I mean, if you're close enough, you can
close
rage.
Yeah. Well, I was just thinking the new troll warlock, the one who came in the battle box, he has a strength buff.
Yep.
So you put that on.
Wait a minute, Greg, is that a not painted model? How dare you?
We did put the caveat in, this is not normal armies, so painting might not be 100% here. It's also why I have not played in these games, it's because my painting is not 100% ever.
Yeah. You know, you do what you can. So it looks like we got the Mauler sitting in front of a Chronicler, the champions to the left with Janissa and Lanyssa in front of her, the two lights over on the right, and Madrak hiding out behind the forest. So Greg's going to go, he's going to run Madrak into the forest. But the scenario, by the way, we've got two flags, control for one, dominate for two, pretty standard.
And actually, I think we have a little less terrain than we normally do. There seems to be a lot more open space.
Yeah, especially on Todd's side. So we have five pieces. There's, six technically. There's a house on the left side, forest on the right. Tiny piece of rough terrain in the middle, then a larger piece of rocky terrain, which is rough terrain. Lake on one side and a hill on the other. Todd measuring to see if he can charge that.
Todd's already planning on the troll's demise.
Oh, yeah.
Well, he is playing circle, so they are speedy little people. I mean, just the advance on and the charge, he might even be able to make it get Hunter's Mark out and just fly.
Yeah, so Todd's playing Kromac2. He's got a full unit of Skinwalkers with Deer UA. He's got Summoning Stones, or Wayfarer Stones, whatever they're called. Of course.
The Teleporty Stones.
Yeah. He's got, let's see, there we go. You got a Feywolf, Warpwolf, and a Warpwolf Stalker. Yeah, Shifting Stones, and a Blackclad Wayfarer, who has Hunter's Mark. So, not Lanyssa, but Lanyssa.
Did the Warpwolf UA still give them the two swings?
Nope, so the Warpwolf UA gives them Nighthouse, which is their mini feat, which is 3-inch AoEs around each model where other guys can't cast spells.
Okay.
And he gives them Gang.
Oh, Gang is nice. Gang it's not as nice. Good as Cleave, but it's nice. And they have Unyielding, so that's always nice.
Right, and it puts them up to Mat 8, Power Strength 14.
So it looks like we're moving up. Trolls are just kind of chugging along.
Yep. The
5-inch AoE, I believe, is the hill.
Yeah, Janissa, with a J, puts up a hill, and you put the champions up on top. So they have their defensive line, plus elevation, nice plus 4 to defense. And then Chronicler comes up and
deals something. The shifting stones, otherwise they can't come on. They don't have a move.
Oh, yeah.
All models that can't move get placed. Right on the edge of the board.
Yeah, double checking the shifting stones here. I think the first time we've had them.
If I remember, don't they have advanced deploy?
So they do have advanced deploy.
You can put them 6 inches out.
Yeah, so you can still AD normally. Yeah.
Just had to clarify something for the rumble. I've run into that same exact situation. So the issue we had was that they were curious as how the shifting stones deployed because they don't have a movement. So they are advanced deploy, so they can be placed 6 inches on. But there is a caveat in the rumble rules: if a model does not have enough movement to get on the board, it can be placed against the board edge. And that was put in there for things like the Conquest, which doesn't have enough movement to make it on the board.
We gotta do Colossal in these games. Definitely something we haven't seen yet.
It's hard at 35 points.
It is. It's a lot of points, but
it's doable. It's just difficult. You end up having a caster, a Colossal, and like four models.
Yeah. Right. So tossing in his first turn, placing down those stones, eating him out,
making his triangle. Gotta have the triangle. Get a really big triangle. If I remember correctly, they don't have a unit leader, so they have to just stay within command of each other. I think is the way it works.
You can take the UA, though.
If you take the UA, it counts as the officer, I think.
Yeah.
As you can tell, we're not very familiar with Circle here. We don't, for whatever reason in our meta, we don't really have a lot of Circle players. Yeah. We've gotten some new ones, but we're still waiting for them to come up to speed. So
I think this is one of our few Hordes matchups as
it
well.
It is. It is, it is. We tend to have a lot more War Machine players in our little group, but I think that's also because of Mark III. I think the power-up rule in Mark III made a lot of people, even who had Hordes as their main faction, kind of drop it for their alternate War Machine faction and so on.
Yeah. And not that we're trying to say it's more powerful or anything, but it made them viable and people were excited to play things that they...
Well, and it's different, you know.
Always play. Yeah.
Play with the power-up rule. It's certainly a very different experience. And the other thing is the issues with Scorn. We had a few Scorn players, and the current Scorn issues have made it, you know, unfortunate.
All right, so here's a strong line of Warpwolves, Kromac2, and Skinwalkers.
The coming of the wolves.
And let's see if can't get to that troll already, because you get Hunter's Mark, which is plus 2 move. Wolves are pretty fast to begin with.
Well, speed 6 plus 3-inch charge is 9.
Yep.
Plus reach is 11, plus Hunter's Mark is 13. I mean, it's doable.
Especially with the Warpwolf Stalker. Because, yeah, he has reach, and he's got Lightning Strike.
Mm-hmm.
So get in and get out.
Get in there, do some damage, get out. Maybe even the champions, you know, go in there and just do some damage and get the hell out. Because he's got Berserk, right?
The Stalker has Berserk. Yeah. He can shift Berserk.
Just get in there, start mucking things up, and get the hell out.
Oh, yeah, the Feral can warp speed, too.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Soak up the speed.
I always forget about that.
Yeah. Tricky, tricky rules. So here comes the Wayfarer. Max range for Hunter's
Mark. Does he have a Feral? It looks like a...
Yeah, he's got a Feral and a Stalker.
Oh, okay. The model he's got on the table looks like the Alpha.
Ah.
Or the True Blood, rather.
Too many wolves.
They just have different faces.
Yeah.
Oh, there you go. There's your warp speed. Just going in. Warp speed and just going nuts. The real question is he still within Kromac? Actually, no. Is he within the Wayfarer? I think Wayfarer has herding. But he needs to stay within Kromac to keep forcing. Otherwise, he needs someone with herding. Or whatever they call it now.
I mean, Kromac has 14.
Oh, then he should be good. On a rumble field.
Yep.
Well, let's see how it goes.
Plus 2, so I'm mat of 9.
Mat 9. Oh,
nine. Oh, I wonder if you feed it.
Maybe. Certainly be an early feat.
Yeah. Well, I mean, if you're taking out your opponents that heavy already, and if the
Well, it's also Rumble. You could do a lot of things on turn one and Rumble.
Exactly. But the Stalker can get into the those champions as well, because he can Warp Berserker.
Mm.
No, I did not.
Now, if I remember correctly, new Kromac feat, because this is
Kromac 2. Oh, no, he Carnaged. That's
right. Oh, okay.
Because
okay.
The part of the feat is you cast Carnage for free, but he just regular cast Carnage.
Okay.
Which is fine. So, yeah, he's just putting a bunch of damage onto that Mauler.
And he gets
two initial attacks, plus buying up to four.
No, he should get three if it's a Feral. Feral has two hands and a bite.
Does he now?
Yeah. Oh, no, never mind.
Oh, yeah. Oh, no, yeah, you're right.
He does. Two claws and a bite.
Two claws and a bite. And four furry, so yeah. Seven whole attacks.
The Stalker doesn't, and the Pure Blood has a spray, but the Feral has three. I mean, he's not doing a hell of a lot every time, but he just hits so many attacks.
Seven attacks. That's a dead Mauler already. That's rough.
I mean, he's Fury 4, he gets three initials.
Yeah. Looks like he's a little too far out to go after those champions, though. But it does look like he's going to get left out there.
Yeah, but if nothing else, I mean, even if Greg kills that Feral, trading a Feral for the only heavy on the troll side, it's a good trade. In Rumble, it does pay to be aggressive, usually.
Here comes Todd, flanking up the...
using that wonderful pre-measure rule to make sure he can stay out of the defenders. Our champions, rather. Forgive me for... I'm going to mess up a lot of these names because I haven't played against any of these factions in forever.
Keep them just far enough out of charge range, so next turn you can Hunter's Mark them and charge in and wipe them off of the board as well. Mm-hmm.
That, and it's probably going to take most of the trolls to get rid of that Warpwolf.
It really is.
I mean, they're natural defense 14, I believe. I mean, that's pretty good for a heavy.
Well, Madrak does have Guided Hand.
That is true.
He does help with hitting.
Madrak might just go in there and do it himself.
Well, it's only Madrak 1. Granted, he's still pretty beefy on his own. He's still the Axer right there, so. Yeah, it looks like a trade, but it's a pretty decent trade.
It's a very solid trade, though. One, just removing the heavy, but two, removing Rage.
Yeah.
I mean, that's a big deal.
And that's a big tool. So, turn passes to Greg. Manage all the Fury. Let's see what he's going to do. I think ideally you want to try to take out that Warpwolf with as few models as you can.
Trying to check if he's in melee. Because he's got an Axer there with a 2-inch axe.
Just shimmy. Trying to see if you can get a weird charge angle on him.
Get his 3 inches.
Or maybe he's out just use Janissa on him. She's got a rock throw. She's pretty decent.
Crit knockdown? A lot of the rock guys do. I don't remember if she does.
Yeah, some along those lines. Let's check.
I know the regular stone shapers do.
Yeah,
I think that's what he's going for.
Range 8, AoE 3, POW 14, crit hit.
Yeah, I think that's what he's going for because the Warpwolf.
He's more of the Axer.
Yeah, he's doing it. But it wouldn't have been a bad move because defense 14 on a heavy is rough.
Yeah.
I mean, they're only arm 16, I think, if they don't warp armor, but still, defense 14, it's tough. You end up having to boost just to hit it, and then you just don't do the damage you need to do.
I mean, the Axer's...
Axer's going in?
Yeah, the Axer's about 6-2.
Yeah, so he's needing 8s to hit.
Yeah.
But he's only minus 2. I mean, so the damage roll... Oh, there you go. There's a solid 7.
Greg's dice, nice and visible. So, decent damage by attack, but again, the Axer's only got 3.
Yeah.
So you're going to see if you have enough attacks. Oh, boy.
That's pain. That is pain. You buy an attack, you boost to hit it, and nothing. And that puts him at his 3.
So you got a boost to attack. You do decent damage, but you're basically using all of your fury to actually hit.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see what he wants to do with these champions.
Yeah, trying to take a heavy... with light beasts is difficult. It's doable. It's just difficult.
Especially for trolls, but
yeah.
Yeah, again, losing rage. Pretty big.
I think he's trying to just get enough champions in.
Yep. They are... Pell 11 weapons masters.
Mm-hmm.
So Greg's got to be careful not to move that one in front of the Axer, because you take a free strike not only if you leave the front arc, but also if you lean line of sight. So if he basically blocked line of sight, he'd get a free strike to that poor Axer.
That's interesting. I've never run into that issue before.
Yeah, it doesn't come up a ton. It's more scenarios like that where you have something with reach, you're at max reach, and you can kind of squeak something in front, and it's basically so you can't like block line of sight to something and then have that guy get out free without taking the free strike.
First swing doesn't look like it connected. Second swing, there we go. Now we're doing some damage.
Yeah, so
they get two attacks apiece, right?
Two attacks apiece, and the weapons masters. So some
really
good damage on this guy.
Ooh, 11. I think it's only minus 3, so he's doing some damage.
Yep.
There you go.
And he probably chronicled the
strength
on him.
Oh, ooh. Second swing
off. Charge of the trolls.
2 sixes will hit every day. Oh, there we go.
Oof, nice.
You know, sometimes the vengeance felt by the player translates to the dice rolls. Take my Mauler, will you?
There we go. Nice two again. Yeah.
Yeah, the only downside is now he's had that whole unit commit to that. They killed the beast, but the stalker is just like right there.
Yeah, drooling the charge in. There's that one
let me go.
Guy who's on the base soldier, he'll have the lower defense. You get to warp berserk and just start clearing through guys.
It looks like Greg is going to try and use the Impaler to
hope for a crit.
Hope for a crit, or even just get him pushed.
Oh, you have to.
You have to crit for the push?
Yes.
Okay.
It's crit slam on the.
Yeah, I didn't know if it was like Thunderbolt, where it's like a push, and if you crit hit him, it's a knockdown.
You always get it. And I think he might have to snipe too.
Yeah, he's got nothing better to do.
Without the heavy, he's got 3 Furies. He's gonna do
without the heavy anymore. He's got 2 lights worth of Fury management.
Yeah. Well, Madrak doesn't only have 5.
This is
so he might have to be careful about running too hot, because I think he did at least 2 on the Axer.
I think he's got 3 on the Axer, because I think he boosted a hit and then bought and boosted.
Really good roll, but not a crit.
Not a crit.
So he can't boost here.
Oh, -4. He only flinged the 1.
Yeah. He couldn't boost because he has too much fury out right now.
Spear just grazed.
Running no fury management. Not a concern for War Machine players, which Greg normally is. And he used to play a lot of scoring, and you always brought beast handlers, so.
Well, fury Mark management 2
was easy.
Fury management in Mark 2 for most factions was really easy.
Yeah.
I mean, I think trolls were the only ones that didn't have really easy fury management on their beasts.
Right.
I mean, shepherds and beast handlers and I forget what the circle one was called, the wilder.
Yeah, everybody had something. So here comes Madrak shimming up.
Oh, that's true. They have whelps.
They also have whelps.
But there are no whelps in this list.
He's throwing his axe at the black lad.
Take this, man. I think he has stealth.
He's got prowl.
Prowl, right. Yeah. Right. Should have shimmied a little more to that. Oh, prowl only works for woods and clouds, doesn't it?
That should hit. Pretty sure that axe will go right through.
And Madrak said, Hunter's Mark, no more.
Yeah.
And it does trigger Blood Boon, so he gets a free spell out of this.
But Madrak's only got 3 on his card. And Charles already went, so you don't really want to do Carnage. Let's see what he got. He can do Stonefall if something's close enough. And I'm pretty sure he's already got Surefoot up on
the champions.
I'm going to call him Defenders for some reason.
I don't think he's going to be 8 inches to anything.
No.
Mm-hmm.
And it doesn't need to guide his hand anything anymore. So, I think he still has Janissa and Lanyssa to go.
Let's say, doesn't the axe ricochet?
Yeah.
So you should get a hit into that stalker.
Thanks, guys.
You're welcome. Another model with an 4-inch.
Yeah, yep. So he should get that stalker.
Yeah, boost and hit the stalker.
Yeah, he can boost.
Yeah, it's within 4 inches. Ignore range. Ignore light of sight.
At this point, any nickel and dime. That's what you got to do. Just nickel and dime.
So
ooh, ooh, that was actually pretty good.
And there's actually decent damage on that thrown axe too.
15. So it's -2, I think. So yeah, 6. Not bad. Yep. Take what you can get.
Because again, Todd only brought 2 war beasts, and he's down 1 already.
Yep. But Kromac is in and of himself a beast.
He really is.
he's like the butcher of Circle. Funny note here, actually, is the fact because he's playing Kromac 2, both casters have the same weapon.
Oh, yeah.
They both have the Ragnarok axe. I'm pretty sure Kromac will use it better, but he can't throw it, so I guess that's something to be said.
Oh, great. So if he wins now, he's just going to dual wield him.
Kromac 1, but with 2.
There goes Janissa.
Put that hill up.
Put a hill up. I don't know what good that's going to do.
Hills don't block line of sight, so I'm not sure. Whatever.
No.
I think he just really wanted us to be able to discuss why you would put a hill there.
So this is a very interesting move by Greg here. See, what, you can put Lanyssa on the hill and give her that much more defense.
You know, you would think, if she can raise a hill out of the ground, couldn't she just make a divot instead?
Yeah.
Just put it lower.
Make a nice trench. No, I understood all of it. You're a little more useful.
Not sure what we're rolling for here.
Something from the one, I think it's her spray or whatever.
Oh, lovely.
Yep, doing some damage. She's got a... what do you call it? Ice ball.
Yeah.
Which does have crystal story.
It's pretty good. Why not?
Yeah.
Stationary the wolf, that'd be cool. At least make him shake it.
Yeah. I mean, he doesn't really have the Hunter's Mark this turn anyway, so.
He doesn't have Hunter's Mark anymore. The black cat took an axe to the face.
I mean, the Lanyssa's Hunter's Mark.
Oh, right, right.
Yeah.
Keep forgetting.
Right. Looks like that was it.
Trolls passed it over.
Passed the
and they're just waiting to see how Circle takes this. I mean, I think the obvious move would be to have the Stalker going just nuts really and just take as many champions as he can.
Yeah.
But the downside to that is that if he loses the Stalker, he's out of beasts. No transfers. He only gets 2 Fury.
He needs transfers. I'm Kromac 2.
I mean, the new Mark III rules, he would get 2 Fury every turn for having 2 dead beasts, but...
which might be enough.
7 Fury caster, you're going to have to do a lot of cutting to make up for that.
Yeah, but he's pretty beefy.
He is. And I think he heals really easy. If I remember correctly, he's got some weird rule that he heals.
Let's find out. Kromac, champion of the worm.
He's natural 17. That's always nice. Natural
power strength 14, 18, 7 Fury. At 8, yeah. Pound strength 17 on the axe. let's see. Oh, yeah. So he can, when he kills stuff, he gets tokens, and he can use tokens to heal D3.
Oh, Jesus. He has Field Marshal Hyper Aggressive.
Yeah.
Todd could have used that.
Well, Greg has very little shooting.
No, I know, but the axe hit him. He could have Hyper Aggressed forward.
Yeah, he could have. Didn't really need to, though.
Not important. He's got all the distance he needs.
Yeah.
Oh, here we go. Looks like skinwalkers are going nuts.
Oh, yep.
So it looks like he's going to hold off on the stalker to see what falls out of this.
Yeah, they got relentless charge, so no issues going over the rough terrain.
Yeah. It's Circle. They don't typically have any issues with rough terrain.
Well, these guys actually have relentless, not just flat-out Pathfinder.
We live in the woods, but roots confuse us. I believe he's popping his Death Howl as well. Because he's already in there. He might as well.
It only stops spells.
Yeah, but it'll stop Janissa and...
Lanyssa?
Whatever.
Well, yeah. Janissa's out. Lanyssa might be in.
Little elf girl.
Yeah.
Tony doesn't like my nicknames, so I'm trying to avoid them.
Todd might be able to score on that flag now, too. It's kind of hard to tell with that AoE, but...
If this is true.
He kills Lanyssa, then he definitely will.
Yeah.
But there goes one champ. Nope, check for tough. All trolls are tough, Greg. Come on, you should know that. But yeah, these charges are hurting the gang.
And Todd missed the dice bowl.
Looks like he only got the one, though.
Well, I think he only got two in, and yeah. I think he missed the second attack roll.
What happened to me and on healer? Well, they lost, they don't have weapon master.
Yeah.
They do still have 8 points.
Can Kromac get to...
He's debating it strongly.
Magic. No, I don't think so. 14-17. Or though, he might try to get the pure blood in there.
Yeah. The stalker.
Stalker. Warpwolf something or other.
They're gonna teleport from
I'm trying really hard to avoid my nicknames because I remember them by their nicknames.
Ah, here goes Kromac. Stupid teleporting.
But today seems like a good day to teleport.
Yes, sir.
There's the stabby one, the bitey one, the white one.
Shifting stones.
The 8-inch teleport, yeah. I don't think he can move after he does that, though.
Nope, he's got to forfeit it.
Yeah, so he's kind of stuck where he is, but I don't think that's going to be too big of an issue. I think he really just wanted the flag, and he's going to have his stalker go in and just be in the way.
Well, too, everything's nice and in Carnage, Rage, all that stuff.
Mm. Oh. Carnage would have been nice to get the... He should have done that first. Get in there in Carnage and should be like, ha-ha.
He's doing a vengeful on himself for a retaliatory strike.
Yep, that was always good.
Thanks.
Yeah, so he should be able to dominate that flag that he's on.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, there he goes.
Oh, there we go. Natural speed 6, charge 9 with reach.
He warps strength as well. Done.
Well, I think his choices are strength, armor, strength, prowl, and berserk. Yeah. So, all right, going for the magic. He does have a transfer target because the he didn't max out the impaler.
Right, but I think he only has.
Like, I think he only has one. Yeah. So
he's at 18 on the sword.
Mm-hmm.
Which is not too shabby.
Needing six.
So 6 hits on the charge.
Oh yeah, that'll do it.
Okay, that was a hand. So now the.
And then he has the one.
He
once
does have
per
the
game.
Scroll. Yep.
Scroll.
So
now I'm doing the,
so looks like he can pop that.
Six. Nope.
Oops,
there's a dodge.
And right. Start flying more.
There we go.
There's a hit.
Yep. It's probably going to be
18. Oh. 20?
Oh,
yeah, right.
Probably 5 feet.
Yep. So here we go. Let's see what we get.
See if you can burn through him.
So that'll be
11. Oh, jeez. 11. Impaler's taking that one.
Yeah, there goes someone to transfer.
And this is when you watch an impaler twitch. Just a solid 11 to the head.
And let's see if Magic can dodge enough of these other attacks.
I will.
Bad way.
Oh, no, that's a hit.
Yeah. And dice plus 3.
Well, at least that doesn't look so bad.
Yeah. I think that's roll.
Last attack.
Let's see.
One more try.
Just one more.
Let's see how much Todd's dice like it. That's a hit.
Ooh.
Going to go. Going for broke. Oh, that looks good.
Oh, still up.
Just barely. Well, can't forget also there's that infamous tough roll, too.
Yeah. Although if you can get a Kromac in there, Kromac does have grievous wounds.
Well, Kromac's already done.
Yeah.
In fact, I think he's all done. Yeah.
So yep, that's all done.
Trolls, time to recover.
Yeah.
And actually, it looks like Todd got...
But he's got that heavy in his face.
Todd got 3 control points.
Yeah.
Because he got 2 for dominating one flag and 1 for controlling the other. So that's... he's taking a definite lead.
Yep.
And Greg has to,
at
really minimum...
Really bad spot. I'm not sure what he can do here.
At minimum, he has to contest Kromac's flag. He has to contest that red flag no matter what.
At least, I think ideally...
Ideally, like he needs to kill Kromac, but...
Right. I mean, he might be able to clear the Warpwolf in front of him. And then he's got two light beasts that can go on to Kromac. He's
Kromac,
pretty tough.
Kromac's a tough one.
Yeah. He is a tough cookie. So he is, again, 14, 18. And then, I think under feet, he's unyielding. No, just plus two strength, so 14, 20.
Eddie has retaliatory strike.
Yep.
So this really boils down to, if Madrak kills the stalker, can he do enough with two light beasts?
Yep.
To be fair, the champions can do quite a bit of damage to those skinwalkers.
Especially with two attacks apiece.
Two attacks apiece and three of them get charges.
Yep.
So... if nothing else, he might clear out the skinwalkers, and if he can contest the flags so that Todd doesn't score on scenario, he's going to line himself up to be winning on attrition pretty quick.
Yeah. Well, the thing is, he's got to contest both. So
he does have
Todd
to contest both. But if he can reduce the skinwalkers to less than half strength, they can no longer hold a flag. So he only needs to kill four skinwalkers out of that squad, and they can no longer contest or hold.
Yep.
And then if he kills the other beast, then the only thing left is Kromac.
So when this charges in, hits a four skinwalker.
Go elf girl.
I think she's got a weapons master or something, right?
Nah, she only rolled seven.
Here goes Janissa. Janissa has... armor piercing.
Yeah.
So that should carve right through him.
This would be fun.
I mean, it's pound 9, but still armor piercing.
Yeah. There you go.
Nice. So that'll hit.
Yeah, so it's 16 halves to 8 plus 2 for unyielding, so it's 10.
Yep.
So it's minus 1 on 3d6. It would help if he got it inside the... Oh, there we go. It's not going to kill it, but it's going to come close. So
wow.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7
lives to 2
six.
Charges.
Well, to be fair, the elf wasn't much of a charge.
Yeah, true. I mean,
it's like having a gobber charge. I think I'd feel better about the gobber.
Probably would have been better off with the shooting a spell.
Yeah, he probably would have. All right, here we go. Here's what matters.
Try and carve through these guys. Right, trying to remain into base to base for the defensive line.
Yeah. Like I said, he just needs to kill four. If he can kill four of them, he's all set.
So he needs a...
I think I'm at 7, so he needs 6s.
Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah, that's it.
Now comes the hard part. Minus 9s. Oof. That is a good start.
That's a good roll.
Good start. Especially because he only rolled 3 dice there, so I'm assuming that wasn't a charge.
No. I think he had weird angles. Because if you remember, he had to charge the stalker, and he kind of made a ring out of him.
Yep.
So when he was facing that way, couldn't turn around and charge into his back room, so I had to walk around funny. Mm-hmm. No straight lines.
It's unfortunate.
But
he's doing the damage. He's just not getting any off. He's just hitting a little bit of damage to each one. He's got to start removing it.
I mean, at least he's within 4, so he is contesting that flag.
Yeah, but he's minus 9s on 3 dice. I mean, that's tough.
Yeah. 9 being generally average on 3.
He's got to... Yeah.
Oof. Yeah, so nothing on that one even.
Yeah. He needed that charge.
Yeah, big time.
That was...
Yes.
That
just
was
nickel and
diming
these guys.
Yeah, but even at 5 health, he's not even nickeling diming. He's pennying at this point.
Sure. Pesoing. Sorry.
We have no racial discrimination on this show.
It's money discrimination. So here we go, Axer onto the Warpwolf. And this Warpwolf was pretty beat up. Took quite a bit of damage. See if he can finish him off.
It's curious. I think I would have used the caster to kill it, but maybe he thinks he's going to need both.
19. Yeah. Of
or I think he's trying to maybe throw a spear at Kromac, hopefully.
Throw a spear and then throw an axe.
Oh, boy. That makes your heart sink. Not a good damage roll. So Greg's going to try another attack. Looks like he has to boost it, too. And, oh, man.
That just makes you cry. Ooh, that's boy. Just... Well, you tried, buddy.
Greg's best laid plans.
Pat on the head there. You tried.
So what do you do now? Get the impaler into it. You can't leave him there.
What is his feat? What is the troll feat?
Everybody makes a melee attack.
It's what?
Everybody makes a melee attack.
Oh.
Oh. So
he could get another attack with all those defenders. With all the champions.
Yep. But, I mean, again, he's
dice minus nine.
So he could make a.
He needed that charge.
Yeah. Yeah, it's actually a good counter.
Ooh, that was a good roll.
All right. Oh, yep. Looks like he threw a spear into Kromac there.
Yep.
Didn't crit there, though.
And Kromac has like 20 health, so.
Yeah. Magic moving back to max range.
Mm-hmm.
That's 14.
All right, he's going to try and take out the stalker on his own. Man up.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
He'll pop the feet.
Greg pops feet
now. Everybody gets to swing.
So Axe is going to hit first. But,
now he is.
Oh, there he is. Dice by six, though.
Every time.
Just the dice not with Greg at all.
Yeah, that's painful. Just being one off or two off. And
I mean, it's nice that you get all the extra attacks, but...
You know what I feel it is.
You can't boost her or anything like that, so you're... Again, like the feet, you give you the plus two armor. It's still huge.
Yeah, you know what this is, right? This is the karma that Greg has received because he refuses to stop using the slanty dice on our camera game. So karma has weighed down on him to tell him, do not do this.
Well, I've got used to reading them. They're not that bad. The thing is, they're nice and big, so you can see the pips.
They are.
They don't have any funky spirals or designs or anything like that.
Oh. This is just not... This is like watching a train wreck in slow motion. You really want to root for it, but...
I killed one of them!
Greg killed a skinwalker.
Lots of excitement there.
Woo!
Removed one. After many, many attacks.
After what?
Four hits into it with the regular stuff and another one for the
feet. Well, yeah, he charged the Janissa one that's over. Got has
two.
Four champions with two attacks apiece and then feeded for one more attack apiece. And I should kill one.
Yep. Going back to that stalker, putting some more damage in. This is his caster. Ooh.
Oh, man.
His caster trying to get some work done. Ooh, there we go. There we go. That's a damage roll.
Nice. Finally dropping for Greg. But the stalker is still not dead.
No.
It just refuses to go down. Zoom-type. There we go.
There we go.
1 point.
Should have just boosted damage at some point. Can he kill him? Ugh. Four more damage? Not quite enough. Oh. Last deck now. Ah, finally.
There we go.
It only took three models and a feat.
Now he runs into the problem that he needs to contest or Kromac wins. So what is he going to do? Run the Chronicler within four and just pray? He is a solo. He can contest.
Yep. Yeah, that's exactly what he's going to do.
He's just going to run them within
run the
four.
You don't have this flag.
Yeah, but I think you just put him in Kromac's melee range.
he doesn't care. He's in the way. He's there to contest a flag and stop Kromac from getting into something scary.
Yep.
And then you get an
yeah, but now all Todd has to do is just activate Kromac, kill him, and end his turn.
Go. Yeah.
It's literally all he has to do is just cleave him. Unless that Axer is within four, but I don't think so.
No, I think it's a regular one. I mean, it might be, but he might, Greg, just might try to be clogging out some charge lanes instead. I guess we can ask. Nah, I don't want to talk to these guys.
Well, I mean, Todd isn't going for the quick win, so I'm assuming that Axer is within contesting range.
Yeah.
That end champion might be, too.
No. Oh. Yeah, so the that little bit of damage that Greg did do to the skinwalkers, they all heal free at the beginning of their turn. Yeah.
Well, that's salting the wound right there.
Yeah.
That's Todd just ripping open the salt bag and just packing it in.
Seeing if Kromac can walk. And,
oh, there's a nice picture of the back of Todd's head.
Back of Todd's head. Isn't it nice? Thin it a little bit.
Yeah, we're, if he leans a little to the left, we can check for lice.
Yeah. Is that a mole or a tattoo? So seeing if I think Kromac can walk up to that Axer easily. Because yeah, there's Carnage. Magic has nothing left on him.
Oh.
Yeah.
Kromac's just having fun at this point. Things to kill. Must kill them.
So getting just within two.
Yep.
No. Yeah, no, definitely not.
Oh, he's looking, I think, for the looking to see. I wonder if Kromac is overtaken.
Oh, stupid fun guy.
I can look.
Oh, he's got retaliatory strike.
He does have retaliatory strike.
So,
and magic.
Oh, I have two health points. Swing against
the Axer.
Alright, so Kromac's going nuts against the Axer.
Oh, he's got his spell, that's right. Hang on. Kromac does actually have a really nice offensive spell.
Mm-hmm.
In, what's it called? Primal Shock. Which is based off his own strength.
So yeah, like, but he needs to choose a friendly faction, War Beast. He doesn't have any.
Never mind.
Oh, all right.
Kromac. No, I don't know what he's going for then.
I think
maybe
he's just
taking out the beast.
Kromac's like, look, stuff
happy
to kill.
Yeah. He does have heart. Make additional attack, boost mana attacks. No, I guess he just wants to kill that Axer.
It's like Butcher, you know? It doesn't have to make sense. It's just fun to roll a lot of dice and kill things.
I do love myself a Butcher. Buying attacks until this Axer is dead.
Just keep swinging. Just, oh, there it goes.
Yep.
Didn't take that long. Well, natural 17 will do that for you.
Yeah. So,
that guy swings like a freaking ironclad. Just draw.
Oh, looks like he's going to take the attack on that little Chronicler, too.
Just taking out his anger on everything.
Mm-hmm.
And tough it.
No, he grievous wounds.
Oh.
And another corpse token for Kromac as well.
You don't get the tough. Kromac eats you.
So Kromac basically gets to use the corpse tokens as basically kind of fury.
Yeah, or
boost
healing.
Attack, boost damage, buy extra attack, and yeah, eat 1/2, heal d3.
Well, I think he's going to have to, because I think he has to cut himself for fury at this point. He only has two coming in. He has no beasts left.
Right. No, he's pretty healthy. I don't think he's got any damage on him, so. It's like one skinwalker is going to charge in,
mm-hmm.
and the other is going to.
This is curious.
Mash
he
up and
he abandoned the flags.
Yeah, but he's winning pretty hard on the attrition, though.
He is, but if he loses Kromac by some weird chance, he just threw the game that he could have won pretty easily. But hey, you know, it is the spirit.
Death of glory. Play for fun. You know what's fun? Winning. Two.
Greg's, Greg's just hoping to push the karma to Todd right now.
Turnabout's fair play. Wolves only get one attack. We're in the gang, so it's up in power.
He only did one. They're holding in there.
Yeah. Not so good without the charge.
Yeah. They're not weapon masters. Come on. So nope. Just, there we go. He killed one.
Power 14s. Did he tough him? Not tough.
He didn't tough roll it.
Greg, did you tough him? Everything's tough. Don't forget.
Trying for the tough roll. Okay, now take it back up.
Now he's dead. I tried.
All right.
You did what I could. But Todd's still got stones to use, too.
He does. He does. He does.
I think they're just going to zip up near Kromac here.
He's going to try and hold the flag with stones.
I guess you can, right?
I don't see why not, unless it's in their rules that they can't. They count as a unit.
Yeah.
It's certainly a weird way to hold a flag, but unless it says in stones that they can't, I don't see why not.
So I think I put them up to four. Or no, two. Oh, I guess they didn't get dominated before. We don't know what's going on. Just guessing. I think it's about time for Greg to call it an orbital bombardment.
Yeah, technically there's nothing in the shifting stone rules that says they cannot hold a flag. So, as long as they touch the flag and keep 50% of the unit in the 4 inches.
So, here goes Greg again, trying to kill,
kill the skinwalkers.
Skinwalkers.
To be fair, at least Todd's unit was just as ineffective as his.
That's true. It's like watching two units of Kiedem and go at each other. Just tickle fights.
It's like tar pit versus tar pit. You just get a bigger tar pit.
Yep. More attacks. Some hits. Some don't. Some damage. Does he kill anything?
Well, it's minus nines, right?
Yeah. I mean, he's well, only minus seven now that feet's down.
Okay.
Oh, he, yeah, killed the UA.
He got one.
Not too bad.
Ooh, there's a good roll, except for it was to hit.
Yep.
And there's a slightly worse roll.
Bad damage roll.
Oh, that's a much better roll. Much better roll.
Yep, so when Greg can actually roll and...
Do they have 8 health or 5?
I think they
skinwalkers? I thought they only had 5, but they might have survived the nerf.
They actually did, yeah. They still have 8.
They have 8. There you go. That's why they're not dying.
Interesting. That they somehow survived all that. No, regenerating the...
Troller. I mean the
Impaler.
Impaler. The Troller. They're all trolls.
And troller.
They're all Troller.
Charging Kromac, trying to go for the assassination. So Greg's going to get one hit and then...
Well, this also has a second strike. Purpose of contesting that flag.
Sure.
Yep.
So I think Todd's signing if he wants to...
Retaliatory? I think he's going to wait for the caster.
Yeah.
Because the he only gets to retaliatory once.
Right.
Retaliatory is only a one-time use. Once per round, I think. That's a decent roll.
That's a good damage roll.
I think his POW is only like 13, but still.
Yeah.
That'll do some damage.
You're boosting, but
I think that was the charge, right?
Yeah. I think he also boosted to attack, so he's only got one left.
Buy another attack, hope for glory.
Yeah, might as well.
He has nothing to lose at this point. And Todd can't transfer anything because there's nothing to transfer it to.
Oh, no.
No.
Magic just runs away.
There's a Kromac over there. I want to keep my axe. is he going to throw it? I think he's throwing the axe at a stone. Or not. Nope. Shifted over to Todd.
Yeah, Greg's only got 3 minutes too, by the way.
Yeah, the timers were another issue that we haven't really talked about, but most of our games tend to run these timers down pretty bad. And
I don't know. I think we've got a pretty even amount. So, yep, Kromac's going to cut.
Well, we did have that one incredibly short game where Thexus killed Kray on turn two.
That was turn one.
Well, turn one of Celifax, turn two total.
Of the not filmed.
We did not film that one, guys. We apologize. That would have been a great game if we had caught that one on tape.
But looks like Kromac's going to go almost up to full. He's got some corpse tokens to munch on if he gets too low.
And so many squishy trolls to hit.
Yeah. Again, he can use them just as fury and to buy attacks and boost and all that good stuff.
Okay.
Then, I mean, he could even just walk himself back into contact with the flag, take out the Impaler, and dominate for the win.
Well, no, I think that champion on the end is within four. He's going to have to get the Skinwalker to kill that last champion at minimum. Yep, Kromac's following your advice. Going with it.
He should have enough to take this guy out.
He's Kromac. He shouldn't need much effort to take a troll, take a Impaler.
He's getting two fury automatically from the two beasts, cut himself, and some corpse tokens. So.
I don't think he needs to cut himself. Just use the corpse tokens.
I think he did that.
Just buy the attacks.
Yep.
And not ones. There you go.
Yeah. And yeah, straight
17
dice.
Straight dice.
Even
take a limb. Oh, that didn't look too good.
Yep. Yeah, the Impaler's already beat up.
Yeah, not well, looking good. He took that 11-point transfer right off the bat.
Yeah.
So even nickel and diming, he's going to kill it pretty quick. They only have like 20 health. They're not they're not tanky.
Interesting that Todd held on to the retaliatory strike because he was already about magic and didn't use against the Impaler. Could have saved him an attack.
True, but I think it was because the retaliatory strike is what made Greg not go in with Madrak, because if he went in and got a retaliatory strike,
yeah,
his beast was already loaded and he would have just died.
Fair enough.
Because I think Madrak only has like 3 health left.
Yeah, so
two health.
So, Madrak there ate his corpse tokens to gain health.
Yeah, why not?
Yep.
You got another one for killing the Impaler, so.
So I think he... Did he do the Skinwalkers yet?
I do not believe so.
No, I don't think so. So he's got them and he's got the stones. Putting stones in the way.
Charge lane blockers.
Yep.
Nice.
Yeah, shifting around to make sure he can gang on that one guy that's within four of the flag.
That's what you gotta do.
Yeah.
They have 2-inch reach, though, so it's not that hard for them to be able to gang.
Yeah. So, trying to take out this guy to basically all win.
Yep.
Run scenario.
That was a miss. Oh, and a miss. That doesn't look like a hit either.
Defensive line plus Surefoot.
Yeah.
What's the defense actually?
16,
really good.
I think. 12 plus 4.
Yep. On medium-based weapons masters. Pretty nice.
Mm. Too shabby. Tough weapon masters.
Tough weapon masters. Nope. Lanyssa is dead.
Oh, wait. He's looking for something.
Okay. And now we got dead. Yeah, Lunas is dead. Janissa is okay. Thank you, Janissa.
And people make fun of my nicknames. My nicknames are easier to identify.
There we go. You have to make sure you emphasize the right syllable.
Tough.
He failed the tough. He rolled the low. Yep. She is not tough. Greg has not had good luck on the tough rolls.
And now we know why Greg does not play trolls.
It's a size, it's a champs are five man, rather, normally.
Yes.
So at least they can still contest. I'm not going to answer that question. Yeah, the one up.
Yeah, but they're not in a position to contest anything.
Well, the one on the left is should be within for the blue flag.
Taking swings on the stones. What's the stones?
5, 8.
Oh, yeah. So, shifting over to Greg. Looks like he's going to try and clear out the stones.
You know, actually, now that I think about it, I'm pretty sure you need 50% of the unit within 4 to contest, not just one model.
Really?
Yeah, for units. I'd say our judge is looking for it, but he's too busy playing with his table. So our Crackerjack judge is all over this.
That's a... Crackerjack, ouch. So I don't know if Greg wanted, I guess it's a good idea to kill the stones. He's just opening up a charge line.
Killed the stones, ended his turn. Well,
yeah.
I think Todd's going to get what he always wanted, Kromac versus Madrak.
Don't know if it's even worth it to take the time to try and attack the skinwalkers here.
He could just win on scenario, but no, he's going to smite Madrak into the dirt.
Yep. Yeah, so Todd getting two more fury. Yep, he's going to carnage and charge. Again, for Madrak.
Do nothing.
Nothing to transfer to. Grievous wounds, so.
Same weapon, same range.
Tough doesn't matter.
Yeah, tough doesn't save him. Natural 17.
He does. 6 to hit.
I think this will finally answer the question, who is better with Ragnarok?
Yeah.
And Kromac says no.
It's a 6 to hit. That'll hit. So, dice.
There's no tough roll. It's Grievous
Wounds. No tough roll. Yeah.
And no obliterated.
Minimum damage kills him. That's it. Checkmate.
All right. Well, thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I think, honestly, Todd had planned this out in his head the whole time. Must kill, must kill, must kill, must kill, must kill. There was no winning on scenario. I'm Kromac.
He traded really well.
That one. I was like, wait a minute,
I'm Kromac. It was his heavy for the Mauler.
Yeah, that first trade set a precedent for the game
really
right
well,
there.
But then,
heavy versus heavy.
Yeah, Greg had to commit hard for that one, but that let the everything else just kind of start with doing a lot of damage.
But yeah, thanks for watching, and we'll hopefully you'll watch the next one too.
Yeah, please.
So, sorry, bro, tough loss. What did you think of your list and the matchup?
My list is actually kind of something fun. So, like was mentioned in the game, Trolls actually isn't my faction. It's actually Tony's faction, but I decided to play it for fun. It was a list that I built back in Worm just for fun, and the idea is just get the champions to have really high defense. You put Surefoot with Madrak, and their defense 16 in melee, and then if you do the Stone Scribe Chronicler and Janissa with the hill, you get them up on top of the hill, and their defense 18 against shooting. So you can't hit them. They hit pretty hard, and the Impaler with Madrak, so he can throw his axe and bounce it off of stuff from range. I thought it would be kind of fun. There's also the shenanigans with casting Rage on the Impaler so that the throw hits harder.
It would have been nice to hit harder with a Rage, but I saw the Mauler got eaten up pretty quick there.
Yeah, that's the Rumble format. He was about a half inch too far forward, and that's what got him killed.
Yep, that'll do it. And then
that was it.
Yeah, I think from there it was pretty bad trades for you overall, so you lost your heavy, took his heavy, but he had to kind of commit a lot to that, so then he was able to come in with all the skinwalkers, which did some decent damage.
Well, the champions and...
they at least tidied each other up.
Yeah, they tar-pitted the crap out of each other. During Kromac's feat turn, I was rolling dice minus 9.
Yeah.
So it wasn't difficult to hit, but I'm just come on dice spikes, and it wasn't happening.
Yeah, even with Weapons Master and stuff to get through that.
We were just kind of sitting there flailing at each other. It was fun.
So think you change anything with the list, or?
Not really. Better positioning with the Mauler. I mean, just having him die turn one without doing anything really affects how the list played, but even turn one losing my heavy, I still kind of came back. It was Kromac and some Skinwalkers versus Madrak and some champions at the end.
Yep.
So I like the list. Kromac is a beast. The Skinwalkers are ridiculous. I didn't realize that they still have 8 wounds.
Yeah, somehow they survived that.
Yeah, somehow they survived that. That was not a good thing to find out. They were hard enough to kill because they're arm 18 because of unyielding. They have 8 wounds and then they heal. Yep. Themselves, which, yeah. That was fun.
Good game, though. See you next time.
Pound it, yeah.
All right. Up next, we're going to talk with Todd, the winner, as always.
I don't win all the time.
Not all the time, just most of the times.
Just sometimes.
So, what did you think about Kromac? What did you think of the list?
First time playing Circle, first time playing Kromac, first time playing anything that's a buff army, I loved it. Normally, I Quicks player, Legion of Everblight. I'm all about debuffing and manipulating the opponent. This time, I'm just buffing out my army and seeing up how much I can Hulk smash them. Rather enjoyed it. The list itself, I was trying to build it for a new segment that we're going to do about the, it's like a on a budget list.
Mm-hmm.
So that list right there costs around a little under $200 for for 35 points. Ideally, having just two heavy war beasts in 35 points is tough, because I find with hordes you need at least three to play around with.
Yeah, we did notice that, because after you lost the two, you're relying on the two, and then you had to cut to the shield yourself a couple times.
I figured with Kromac, it's not that big of a deal, because as soon as he's killing living models, he's healing D3 every time with those corpse tokens,
yep.
So he can survive a turn or two with doing that. I think ideally, instead of like Shifting Stones, Warwolves would love this list.
You're not going to take Shifting Stones?
I know, right?
I'm well aware.
But in this particular list, I think Warwolves just synergize a lot better with the Skinwalkers. They'll have Sikkim, and they'll have power strength like 13s on the charge. But yeah, keeping Shifting Stones for higher points, definitely. But if the points were allowed, I would probably grab Warwolves instead.
I did like the all-Werewolf army. Really appreciative of that.
Yep, I tried. I think Getorix would have been a good choice as well. Using Overtake, he probably would have gone through all of those troll champions if I dropped a couple things. But yeah, the idea was pretty much just to bulk up my strength as much as possible. I would love to have done like Primal Spirit and shoot with like Power Strength 15s.
Yep.
But I just had to commit to kill the Mauler and then heavy things on top of that. I might have had Madrak with a Stalker at that point, but it was bad dice rolls.
It happens, but at the end of the day, you're victorious.
My axe was better.
Your axe was better.
Yeah.
All right, good game.
Thanks, sir.
See you again. Oh, man. Oh, so bad.
You guys are dorks.